I'm going to talk about something now that sort of splits the crowd a little bit. Gun control. Now, mate, wait, before you get, don't get excited because the other people have guns. The anti-gun people are like, yeah, do it, Jim. No, let's just shh. Now, before I start saying this, I want to say this, right? I believe in your right as Americans to have guns. I'm not trying to stop you from having guns. All I'm saying is this is my personal belief on the opinion. My opinion on the... it doesn't matter. I don't like guns, right? I'm going to say some things that are just facts, right? In Australia, we had guns, right? Right up until 1996. And in 1996, Australia had the biggest massacre on earth. Still hasn't been beaten. And... Now, after that, they banned the guns. Now, in the 10 years before Port Arthur, there was 10 massacres. Since the gun ban in 1996, there hasn't been a single massacre since. I don't know how or why this happened. Maybe it was a coincidence, right? Now, please understand that I understand that Australia and America are two vastly different cultures with different people, right? I get it. In Australia, we had the biggest massacre on earth. The Australian government went, that's it, no more guns. And we all went, yeah, right then, that seems fair enough, really. Now, in America, you have the Sandy Hook massacre where little tiny children died, and your government went, maybe we'll get rid of the big guns? And 50% of you went, fuck you, go take my guns! So here's where it gets confusing, right? Now, as I said, I'm all for your Second Amendment rights. I think you should be able to have guns. It's in your constitution. What I am not for is bullshit arguments and lies. There is one argument and one argument alone for having a gun, and this is the argument. Fuck off. I like guns. It's not the best argument, but it's all you've got. And there's nothing wrong with it. There's nothing wrong with saying, I like something, don't take it away from me, but don't give me this other bullshit. The main one is, I need it for protection. I need to protect me, I need to protect my family. Really? Is that why they're called assault rifles? Is it? Never heard of these fucking protection rifles you speak of. Protection? What the fuck are you talking about? You have a gun in your house, you're 80% more likely to use that gun on yourself than to shoot someone else. And people think, well, that'd never happen to me. You don't know that, because you know what? From time to time, we all get sad. One day you're happy, then you're sad, and then, it was... Protection. I had a break-in in Manchester, England, where I was tied up, I had my head cut, they threatened to rape my girlfriend, they came through the window with a machete and a hammer, and Americans always go, well, imagine if you had a gun. And I'm like, all right. I was naked at the time. I wasn't wearing my holster. I wasn't staring at the window waiting for cunts with machetes to come through. Like, what world do you live in where you're constantly fucking ready? You have guns because you like guns. That's why you go to gun conventions. That's why you read gun magazines. None of you give a shit about home security. None of you go to home security conventions. None of you read Padlock Monthly. None of you have a Facebook picture of you behind a secure door going, fucking yeah. Like you're going to be ready if someone comes into your house. You have it at all fucking time. By the way, most people who are breaking into your house just want your fucking TV. You think that people are coming to murder your family? How many fucking enemies do you have? Jeez, you think a lot of yourself if you think everyone's coming to murder you. See, if you have it readily available, it becomes unsafe. You have it in your bedside table, one of your kids picks it up, thinks it's a toy, shoots another one of your kids. Happens every fucking day. But people go, that'd never happen in my house because I'm a responsible gun owner. I keep my guns locked in a safe. Then there's no fucking protection! Someone comes into the house, you're like, wait there, fuckface. Oh, you've come to the wrong house here, buddy boy. I'll tell you what, I'm gonna fuck you up. Okay. Is it 32 to the left or 32 to the right? Your mother's birthday? Why the fuck would I know your fucking mother's birthday? Maybe if you didn't leave the window open, because it's too hot in here, we wouldn't be getting fucking murdered, right? I find the NRA to be hard work. But the fact that they always think the answer is more guns. After Sandy Hook happened, the NRA said, and I quote, "None of this would have happened if the teachers had guns." I think they're forgetting what school was like. Does anyone remember that casual teacher that used to, whenever she came onto school, that relief teacher came, you and your friends would see her and go, "Oh, we're gonna make her cry." And then she'd stand in front of the class with a bit of chalk and her hands would be shaking. And you go, "You're never getting married, are you, miss? Never gonna happen for you." Then she'd get back to a 1967 Volkswagen Beetle. She'd be crying over the steering wheel, just, "Why don't they like me? Let's give that cut a gun and see how things work out." And then they go, "Oh, well, answer to that, we'll just add more guns." They go, "We'll put an armed security guard at every school across America." Yeah, that'll work out. The average security guard in America earns $16 an hour. Not a lot of wiggle room to be a fucking hero. Someone comes onto the school and you've got Kevin. Now, I'm sure Kevin's shit hot at Call of Duty, but it might not fucking cut it, ladies and gentlemen. Now, I understand that when I'm doing this joke in this room, 50% of you agree with me, 50% of you don't agree with me, and I do respect the people who don't agree with me. Don't think I don't. Out of the 50% that don't agree with me, 20% of those people are smart enough to realize this is a comedy show and it's not to be taken seriously, and they're laughing along because it's just funny jokes, right? And then the next 20% are sort of phased out a little bit and looking around going, "Wonder how they got that chandelier up there." And then there's the last 10%, and they're fucking furious. Right now in this room, and the people watching at home, 10% of you are fucking seething. Just. And for a couple of reasons. First reason, I'm making good points. Second reason, and this is the big one, I'm foreign. And that's pissing the fuck out of you right now. And your brain is on a loop and you can't fucking turn it off. And it's just going around in a circle and you're just going, "If you don't like it, go home. If you don't like it, go home." And my answer to that is no. Came here legally, I pay my taxes, I say whatever the fuck I want. Your First Amendment means that I can say the Second Amendment sucks dicks. And unless you're an American Indian, you're a fucking immigrant as well, so fuck off. People get so precious about it. Like, I understand that to Americans, your constitution is very important. I respect it, but please understand that every country has one as well. It's no more special than any other constitution. We have one in Australia. I don't know what it says. I've never seen it. If there's a problem, we'll check it, but everything's going fine. And don't get me wrong, I get that the Constitution's important to you. I get it, right? I've had people come up to me in my face and scream at me in car parks as I'm leaving the theater, going, "You cannot change the Second Amendment." And I'm like, "Yes, you can. It's called an amendment." Like, if you can't change something, it's called an amendment. See, many of you need a thesaurus more than you need a constitution. And if you don't know what a thesaurus is, get a dictionary, work your way forward. don't think your constitution is set in stone. You've changed things before. You used to have prohibition in there, right? And then people were like, hey, who likes getting fucked up? Yeah, I like getting fucked up too. Let's get that one out. Let's get that one out. You used to have this other thing in America called slavery. And then Lincoln came along and went, that's it, no more slaves. And 50% of you went, fuck you, don't take my slaves. And then the same bullshit arguments came out that you have with guns. Why should I have my slaves taken off me? I'm a responsible slave owner. I am trained in how to use my slaves safely. Just because that guy mistreated his slaves doesn't mean that my rights should be taken away from me. I use my slaves to protect my family. I keep my slaves locked in a safe. That's the thing. Why should I have my guns taken off me? I've done nothing wrong. Look, I agree with you. If you're a responsible gun owner and you don't fuck around with them, then you should be allowed your guns. You really should. But that's not how society works. We have to play to the 1% that are such fuckwits they ruin it for the rest of us. We have to walk as slow as our slowest person to keep society fucking moving, right? I take drugs like a fucking champion, right? We should all be allowed to take fucking drugs, but we can't, can we? Because Sarah took drugs and she stabbed the fucking kids. Oh, thanks, Sarah, you fucked it up for everyone, right? Everyone should be allowed to drive their car as fast as they can do it, right? But we can't because Jonathan got drunk and ran over a family. Thanks, Jonathan! Now I have to drive at 30, you fucking idiot! See, that's the thing. Why should I have my guns taken off me? I'm responsible just because that guy's crazy. Who's to say you're not crazy? That's the thing about crazy people. They don't know they're crazy. That's what makes them crazy. The only thing you know for sure on this earth is I think, therefore I am. You know that you exist. Anything past that is open to interpretation, right? You know you exist and that's it. Right now, I think I'm in Boston talking to 1,200 people. That's what I think I'm doing. But there is a good to fair chance that I'm in a mental home standing in front of a white wall going, I hate guns, I hate guns, I hate guns. See, one of the better arguments is, well, if you take the guns away, then only the criminals will have guns. Not true. When they banned the guns in Australia, it worked. When they banned them in Britain, it worked. Okay. That Bushmaster gun that the kid was going to use in Sandy Hook cost like $1,000 American. You can buy it in Walmart. It'll be delivered to your house. That's it, man. $1,000, right? That same gun in Australia on the black market costs $34,000. Now, if you have $34,000, you don't need to be a criminal. You've got $34,000. You're a great little saver. Keep going. So that covers the criminals, but that doesn't cover the people who want to murder your family, that are coming after you and your family. It kind of does. Like, the people who do the massacres, it covers them. Because, okay, the kid at Colorado who thought he was the Joker, let's say that he had some social issues. The kid at Sandy Hook was Asperger's as fuck. Right? I don't know if you know a lot about the black market, but you can't just rock up at the docks going, guns! Who wants to sell me a gun? Now, I'm going to wrap this up. We won't talk about it anymore. Now, see, the one thing that I do really agree with the right to bear arms, I really agree with that the real reason it was written was so that you could form a militia to fight against a tyrannical government. In case the government became a bunch of cunts, you could all get your guns and fight back. And that's why it was written. Yeah! And that made a hell of a lot of sense when it was just muskets. But you do know the government has drones, right? You get that? You're bringing guns to a drone fight. Like, if we went back to muskets, I'm all for it. Keep the Second Amendment. If we all have muskets, muskets are awesome. Every cunt should be carrying a musket with them at all times. You know what's good about the musket? It gives you a lot of time to calm down. Someone calls your wife fat and you're like, fuck you, buddy. You're not a bad guy, you're all right.